be the name of the Lord our God, who redeems us from sin and death, for us and for the salvation of all, Christ be obedient unto death, and death on a cross. Blessed be the Lord our God. Let us pray. O Christ, help us to relive this day in your life, that we may relive your life in our day. You went to your death, the innocent for the guilty, the gentle for the violent, the obedient for the rebellious, opening not your mouth. Now we have learned that before our world can experience a resurrection like yours, we must experience a death like yours. Teach us how to die as you die, O Christ, that we might live as you live, for God, enduring the cross and despising its shame. The hymn, Beneath the Cross of Jesus.
Sorry, I had the wrong page marked.
Beneath the cross of Jesus, I faith would take my stand.
And
seated, please. Today we shall have the seven readings from the cross. In some denomination, they call it the seven stations of the cross, the seven words from the cross. And so, after each reading, we will have a period of 30 seconds silence, and then we move on. The readings and this period will go unannounced. The first reading.
Father, forgive them, for they know not what they do. Today you shall be with me in paradise.
Woman, behold your son, behold thy mother.
So divine demands
my God, why hast thou forsaken me? I thirst. Oh,
tremble, tremble. Were you there when they laid him in the tomb?
It is finished. Father, into your hands I commend my spirit.
Down the Via Dolorosa in Jerusalem that day, the soldiers tried to clear the narrow streets, but the crowd pressed in to see the man condemned to die on Calvary. He was bleeding from a beating, there were stripes upon his back, and he wore a crown of thorns upon his head, and he bore with every step the scorn of those who cried out for his death. Down the Via Dolorosa, called the Way of Suffering, like a lamb came the Messiah, Christ the King. But he chose to walk that road out of his love for you and me. Down the Via Dolorosa, all the way to Calvary. Blood that would cleanse the souls of all men made its way through the heart of Jerusalem. Down the Via Dolorosa, called the Way of Suffering, like a lamb came the Messiah, Christ the King. But he chose walk that road out of his love for you and me. Down the Via Dolorosa, all the way to Calvary.
Crucifixion was a common thing during the time of the Passover, Jews would carry their lambs and the animals to be sacrificed. And those animals that were pure, deemed pure, were sacrificed, and their blood were taken into the temple. That was as a sign of the atonement. But there was also human sacrifice. The criminals who were found guilty, tried and found guilty, were taken outside of Jerusalem in the place called Golgotha. And one needs to get a vision of what Golgotha is all about. Because on the mountain where the cross was staked, at the foot of the cross was a pit. And the pit was there to collect the blood of the criminals. Because to them, the blood was not good enough for the altar. The blood was not good enough for atonement. And the blood was not good enough for anyone to mingle with. So the blood of the criminals went into that pit called the Pit of Sheol. Or in common terms, we call it the Pit of Hell. The person who was crucified was hung on a cross and left there to die from dehydration, starvation, or stress. The person was left in the open on the mountain of Golgotha to suffer there and die. What happened to Jesus at the Feast of the Passover was worse than they ever treated any criminals. They tortured him from Bethany to Jerusalem and from Jerusalem to Golgotha. They were not supposed to beat any criminal or to break their bones. But they beat Jesus mercilessly. And they drove a spear in his side, plotted a crown of thorn and pierced him in his head as a sign that you are a mess. You are making a mockery of the kingdom of God. You claim that you are a king, but to crown you as king, we will use this crown of thorn. Because you are foolish. So Jesus did not only go through physical pain. The mental torture was unbearable for any ordinary human being. He was there in Jerusalem to celebrate the Passover. Like any ordinary Jew. But he was tried before Pilate. And when found guilty, he was sent to Golgotha, to the place where criminals are crucified. And his blood flowed from the cross into that pit of hell. And there it mingled with the blood of the criminals. Another thing to bear in mind is that while others were made to carry the cross for the criminal to Golgotha from Jerusalem, Jesus was made to carry his own cross until they realized that they were breaking the law. So they didn't give him the dignity as they gave to the ordinary criminals. Jesus' crucifixion was the worst because he carried the cross. On the cross, one sensed the anguish and the agony and the pain and the suffering that Jesus endured. Anguish and pain that the human body could not bear. And when that pain and that anguish came upon him, he cried out, "Eloi, Eloi, lama sabachthani? My God, why have you forsaken me?" Everyone who carries a cross sometimes feels that he or she is alone in the bearing of the cross. And even though his mother was there, his disciples were there. His friends witnessed the crucifixion. He did not take comfort in their physical presence. The comfort Jesus wanted was their allegiance and their commitment to the kingdom of God. And he didn't find it in his disciples at that time. At the trial, when they said to Peter, "We saw you in the presence of this man, Jesus of Nazareth." Peter, who had long promised Jesus that even though I go to my death, I will not forsake you. Peter was so concerned for his personal comfort that he said to the people, "No, I do not know him." three times he denied his shepherd. And when the other disciples thought that they too would be brought to trial, they deserted him. Followers of Jesus, look out. Whenever you are called to bear the cross, at a time when you need those whom you have helped the most, maybe the time they will forsake you. Do not be surprised. But what Jesus did on that Good Friday is the greatest miracle ever worked. He bore a cross that was a lifeless piece of wood, which was a symbol of humiliation and shame, equivalent to the gallows. And when he died on that cross, Jesus transformed that cross from a symbol of shame and disgrace to a symbol of God's redemptive act. Now the cross has become the Christian symbol. That which was a symbol of shame and disgrace has now become the most prominent icon in the Christian faith. Christ transformed that which was lifeless, that which was a symbol of shame and disgrace, to a symbol of life-giving and a symbol of God's redemptive act. That's why today, on Good Friday, we sing about the cross. The Apostle Paul said, I am not ashamed of the gospel. Because within the gospel is the cross of Jesus, which is God's sign of redemption in my life. So two things we need to bear in mind about Golgotha and leave with these two things, a place called the skull, because no one wanted to associate with that place. The first was that it was the place where the blood of the criminals, the worst of criminals, were kept. Or you may say the worst of sinners, collected in that pit of hell or Sheol and left there. What happened on that Good Friday is that Jesus' blood, the innocent blood, mingled with the guilty. Sign that hell has no power over those who trust in God. That no one is too far gone to experience God's transformation. Because God comes among us, the chief of sinners, and he mingles with us in order to redeem us. And secondly, if Christ could transform a lifeless piece of symbol, which is a sign of shame and disgrace, into a symbol of God's redemptive act, means that it is easy for Christ to transform you and me. And make us better people. Good Friday is not just about the crucifixion of a man, any man. It is not only about Pilate's trial of a man he deemed as criminal, even though he went against his conscience, because he knew in his heart that Christ was no criminal. It is not just about the Roman swapping the hardened criminal Barabbas for Jesus. Good Friday is about what God has done to redeem all of humanity. Because your blood and my blood are in that pit at Golgotha, in need of redemption. There are many Christian churches that are downplaying this act of crucifixion. But we cannot. Crucifixion is about life. It is about salvation. It is about renewed hope. It is about overcoming trials and obstacles. It is about moving on when others say to us, "You can't." You can say to them, by God's grace, "I can." It is about us taking the journey in life, sometimes with God alone. That when others do not understand our faith and our decisions for Christ, we can say like the hymn writer, "In the cross of Christ I glory, pouring o'er the wrecks of time, all the light of sacred story, gather in his head sublime." We gather to commemorate one of the greatest acts ever done in history. No one else had done it. And no one else could do it. because we all fall short. And before Christ's blood mingled with the blood of the criminals in Sheol, our blood was already in the depth of Sheol. So Christ came, the godly for the ungodly, the righteous for the unrighteous. Thanks be to God for Good Friday. Thanks be to God for Jesus, his courage, his bravery, his dedication, and his sacrifice. They thought that they would have gotten rid of him on the cross on Golgotha. Trials and pain and suffering and heartaches and cries and mourning and grief was upon our Savior Jesus. And they buried him without dignity. But friends, every Good Friday is followed by an Easter Sunday. Amen. Let us pray. Christ, you bore our sins on that shameful cross. Your blood was shed for us. Every cry of anguish and pain was a cry for the redemption of humanity. We messed up. And when it is time for us to pledge our allegiance to you, sometimes we turn our backs and walk away. We admit our failures. There was no sorrow like your sorrow on Calvary's cross. There was never any grief like your grief. And you did it not because you were guilty, not because you were powerless, but you did it because of sacrificial love. love for the world, and love for humanity. So we are ashamed of the way we treat you at times. We are ashamed of our lack of commitment to your service and the petty excuses we use why we should not worship and serve you. Forgive us our sins. And give us the power to overcome our burdens. We pray for those who cause grief on others. Those who inflict pain and laugh and rejoice about it. Have mercy on this sinful world and redeem your world back to yourself. Hear us, good Lord, and answer us. Amen. Let us repeat the words of the Lord's Prayer. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is. Give us this day our daily bread. Forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory, forever and ever. This afternoon at 3:30, we meet here again at the church. Those of you who are willing to go on the walk, meditative walk, we meet here at 3:30. The closing hymn, Jesus, keep me near the cross. There's a precious fountain.
Around me in the cross.
just beyond the river. In the cross, be my glory ever, till my raptured soul shall find rest beyond the river.
God of grace and mercy, go with you from this place as you bear your cross, as you offer thanks to God for Jesus. May you live in hope and find joy even in your sufferings. And may the blessing from God the Father, God the Son, and God the Holy Spirit go with you always. Amen.